have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.
Strength Team family, look, I'm right back with another great video. Today, we got a killer lat workout. One of the Strength Team family members, they came to me and I was like, hey, Real, do you have any workouts that's gonna make my lats grow? I'm struggling, my lats will not grow. I was like, I can make up any type of workout you want. If you come to me and you be like, hey, Real, can you make my pinky toe get bigger and more shredded and more aesthetic? I'm gonna make your pinky toe to be able to make some gains. Any type of workout that you can imagine, I can come up with it and it won't take me long, and I promise you it's going to be game certified. So this workout right here, I promise you, I just finished it. It is going to make your lats feel full. If you do all the stretching like I'm telling you to do between sets, your lats are going to look wide. If you practice this and do this at least 1 to 2 times a week for about 6 to 8 weeks, I guarantee it, you will make at least 1 to even 2 inches of width difference with your lats. But it will not work if you do not work. Follow these, everything I'm giving you, the exercises, the rep schemes, the stretches. If you follow up to a T, my hand to the game, God, you will make some serious gains. We will jump straight into this workout. Our first exercise, we got the wide grip lat pull down. Now, I literally want you to exaggerate. I want you to go super, super wide. You should be at least 4 to 6 inches outside of your shoulder width. What I mean by that, put your hands straight up, and wherever you are, go ahead and move out like 4 to 6 inches. That's how I want you to grab the bar. Now, if you want to, you can go ahead and use straps. I personally like to use straps, but if you don't want to use straps, that is perfectly fine. But go ahead and chalk up your hands. That way you would not be slipping and missing your gains. Now, the main thing to think about when you're doing your lat pull down, pull with your elbows. Do not just pull it down, because if you pull it down, you're going to get a lot of forearm work, you're going to get a lot of bicep work, and honestly, you might even get some trap and some shoulder work. Make sure you are leading the weight with your elbows. We're going to do 4 sets for 6 to 12 reps. We're going to add weight every single set. So what I mean by that, your first set is going to be kind of light. I think I started out with 150 pounds, and then I did 180 pounds, then I think I did 200 pounds, and my heavy set was 220 pounds, and I got that for 8 reps. After finish with that, we got the neutral grip lat pull down. We're going to do 3 sets, 8 to 10 reps. The thing with this is, make sure you keep your chest all the way up and put just a slight arch in your back. That is going to make sure that your lats are going to get that full range of motion. It is perfectly fine for you just to use a little bit of momentum. And I don't mean sit there and be jerking it all the way down. I don't want you to jerk it down, but it is perfectly fine just to use a little bit of momentum to get that weight and the momentum started, and then come down and pull and contract your lats. I want you to do that every single rep, and you know, like the first exercise, add weight every single set. After finish with that, we're gonna do the underhand pull downs. Now I want you to kind of go close, so just put your arms straight up, and wherever they are with your normal just straight up shoulder width, go ahead and turn your hands around and move them in like 2 to 4 inches. This is going to be perfect and we want to hit your lats from a different angle. We're going to do 3 sets, and we're gonna stay between 10 to 12 reps. Try to stay upright as much as possible, but if you have to, you can go ahead and use a little bit of momentum on this exercise too, because I want you to go full range of motion. I want those elbows to be all the way down and somewhat behind you. That way your lats are fully contracted. After we finish with that, we're going to do the dumbbell pullovers. This is just going to tie everything in. We're going to do 4 sets, and we're going to stay between 10 to 15 reps. Now, if you're uncomfortable doing the pullover how I'm doing it, you can just lay on a regular flat bench, and you're still going to make gains. Do not let people lie to you like, well, you ain't going to make no gains if you don't look. Don't listen to them. You're going to get gains whether you're doing it like I am, the old school way, or if you're doing it safer, the way where you just lay straight down on a bench. Because I do it both ways. The only reason I'm doing it this way is because we got another pullover variation after this. But like I say, we're going to do 4 sets, 10 to 15 reps. The main thing to think about is, as you're coming over, make sure you're trying to push your elbows together and squeeze. That way it's going to activate and help you to contract and keep that tension inside your lats. Come all the way across your body right until you get right over your chest, and then after you get to your chest, try to keep your elbows still pushing towards each other. That way it's going to keep that tension, and just come back for that slow and deep stretch and repeat that process. After you finish with that, you got an option. You can either do the decline reverse E-Z Curl Bar pullovers, or if you are blessed to have some resistance bands, go ahead and put 2 resistance bands up on your pull-up station, and then just go ahead and do what I'm doing in the video and just do elbows to your obliques. That is a killer, killer contraction for your lats, and it's a great way to finish it off. If you're going to do the resistance band, you're going to do 4 sets, 10 to 15 reps, or if you choose to do the decline reverse easy curl bar pullovers, we're going to do 3 sets, 10 to 15 reps. It is perfectly up to you. They both are gain certified. It just depends if you have a resistance band. If you don't, just go ahead and do the decline, because I promise you this exercise is great too. Thing with the easy curl bar, you're not going to be able to pull the weight all the way back over you, and that's cool. It's going to be somewhat of a short range of motion, but I promise you, you're going to stretch and contract your lats every single rep. You You can see in the video, it's not a long range of motion, but you can see that I'm contracting and stretching my lats every single rep. The thing that I want y'all to remember about this entire workout, after every single exercise, I want you to do a deep stretch for your lats. You can just put your hands on a pull-up bar and just kind of just hang for a second. You can put one hand up on a pull-up bar, try to push your serratus forward. That way it's just going to open you up and get a deeper stretch into your lats. No matter what type of stretch that you feel comfortable doing, make sure you are stretching between every single exercise. I want you to stretch for at least 15 to 20 seconds. This is going to make sure that you are going to get the most and the maximum gains. Now listen, that's it. This workout didn't take me but like 40 minutes. I promise you this is gain certified. If you're struggling to add some size and some width to your lats, this workout right here is going to help you. You are going to make some serious gains, strength team. So go ahead and try this workout and get those gains. But like I tell you in every single video, make sure you like this video. Make sure you share this video. But at the end of the day, make sure you keep getting them gains.